streamed live on the YouTube channel with full match commentary, every tackle, every pass, every goal, commentary by the legendary Adrian, the man that knows everything. Just to know what PlayStation FC schools confines. And apparently wants it pretty well in the crossbar challenge too. And of course, we'll be asking for your player of the match later on as well. Make sure to follow us on Twitter for results of that at Schools Football. And of course, one of the best things about the PlayStation FC Schools Cup is that teachers can't tie you off for making too much noise.
This is the under-13 PlayStation FC Schools Cup National Final. Chesterfield High School up against Hampton School. Our director's probably had a little bit of a drink here. We've had a little delay. We've all managed to grab a bite to eat. Here we go. This is the correct team. That was the previous match. What a cracker that was. This Chesterfield High School have had a bit of traffic issues. But they are here, they've had their warm-up, and we're kicking off half an hour late. Chesterfield team lining up here. Our two periods of 35 minutes. Sean Beadles in goal, Anthony Seagraves, captain. Ryan Marsden, Joshua Lawson. This is one. Vinu Wawawala. I'm gonna warm up into that name as we go along. Isaac Moran, Sammy Dyer, Harrison Wilson, Noah Roberts, Charlie Hughes, and Dan Gelhardt. As for Hampton, with Seb Routenberg, Freddy Twait, Felix Burt, Adam Malik, Suhu Jin, Alessandro Cardinale, Marcus Solomon, Balti Burtz, Rio Felinoff Stanev, Faris Salmon, and Kasper Strauss. Well, good job I didn't have these team sheets early on. The subs I will just list because they're going to kick off here. I'll read them out for you. Ben Pennington, Tom Windsor, Harry Williams, Alfie Williams, and Harrison Brennan for Chesterfield, and it's Finlay Milner, Ralph Crowther, Alex Watson, Josh Gorgon, and Omer Olser for Hampton. Hampton managed by Mr. Harry Hooper, and Jack Graham is the team manager for Chesterfield. Finn James is our referee, Josh Iyer, Andy Salmon are our assistant referees. Fourth official is Ray Brown. Chesterfield in the navy and gold. Hampton School in the yellow. And, well, we've seen both these schools in previous finals. Certainly remember commentating on a classic Hampton School match. I think it was up at Shrewsbury's ground where the last minute equaliser won them. I think it was after extra time in the end. Offside flag has gone up there. So we're a little bit delayed, and I presume the next kickoff will be 6 o'clock rather than 5:30. Just give every time, every team a chance to have a proper warm up. Just good with Charlie Hughes up front chasing down the goalkeeper here. Here's Malik. And under 13. Full match here. This is the youngest age group that in boys that does play on the pitch. We've seen some 9v9 under 13 games as well. And it's a big, as I've said earlier today, it's actually a pretty big pitch out there as well. So it's this is quite a toughie for these lads. Pitch is in excellent condition. These grounds are really do look after it. The throw from Chesterfield. That's a little push, not given by the referee. I saw that, and I'm up in the high heavens up here at the Hawthorns, looking down on the pitch. Seagraves. Ball played forward. Is coming off Tanner trying to get him back, and here's an opportunity here for Solomon. But he's blocked away. Good defence from Chesterfield. Chesterfield playing right to left here. And the navy and gold. That's a great take from Charlie Hughes. And played out beautifully to the left. Dan Gohart. Looking up. It's a poor ball though, straight to a Chesterfield shirt. Well, early days in this match, of course. The Hampton team have been here a little while, waited a little bit longer for the Chesterfield coach that got held up in traffic. Chesterfield just up the road, probably an hour and a half, maybe. Saneth. This time the referee gives that one. Here's Marsden. Seagraves, the captain, number 3, swung in by Moran. Good tackle there from Wawel Wala. Maybe I'm just going to call him Vinny. Easier name. I'm sorry. I'm going to take the easier option. Ball over the top to Chesterfield handling. these long balls that are coming from the Hampton line. Out wide to Roberts. Roberts inside to Moran. Three players in the box waiting for this. Here's Vinu. Vinu inside to Dyer. Oh, nice run here. And a push from behind. Roberts goes tumbling. And there'll be a free kick in a dangerous position on the edge of the penalty area. Not sure who actually... Yeah, I'd like to have a little look at this again. I don't know if he just overran it himself, but he had a fair bit of pressure here. He nipped in between two. Yeah, there was maybe a little nudge there from the first player. He's forgotten his white tin of paint. No lines anymore. Four on the edge of the six-yard box, right in front of the goal. They've gone short. I don't know if Moran was expecting that himself. He seemed a little bit shocked when it was played square. Usually if it's a set-piece move, he's all just gone to run onto it. And, yeah, he's just saying, you've got to tell me. He's just said to Sammy Dyer there that, what was that all about? Surely there's a little secret code or something. Like, these teams are representing a lot of teams that have entered this competition. I'm just looking at the list. This is round 10. So we're in the thousands range. These are the best two teams. Chesterfield from the north, Hampton from the south. Dyer wants the ball to feet. Sorry, Moran. What a ball from Moran that was. He's got a sweet right foot. Here's Dyer. Dyer unleashed a shot. Pressure all coming from Chesterfield. Moran again. Lots of space in the middle of the pitch. And at the moment, Hampton just chasing shadows a little bit here. Well, there's a good interception. Stanoff is going to be trying to get him on the end of this. He's pumping away. Chester stuck out and... And now, an offside given, which I think is just about right. He looked at just a fraction ahead of the Chesterfield back line as that ball was played. Well, a fair few fans here have come up from Chesterfield. Crossing back post is a chance at almost putting his own goal under such pressure from Sammy Dyer. That was a great cross from Harrison Wilson. And Dyer's coming in at the back post. And, well, this was a heart in your mouth moment if you're a Hampton fan. That ball's coming in and, oh, that's so tough. He's actually done really well there. He got a good foot on that and has put that deliberately well wide. Corner's about to come in. Comes in high, it's a difficult one for the goalkeeper. He was under some real pressure there. He's not a tall goalkeeper. And the Hampton defence give him a big slap on the back. They know that was a tough one. It was difficult at these age groups when you do get sometimes some smaller goalkeepers and sometimes some very big outfield players. I saw the biggest 11-year-old I've ever seen in my life yesterday. So 6'4", we believe. He's too scared to go and ask him. Here's Vinu, knocks it in. There's a little touch over. Chance here for Moran. And the goalkeeper's out sharply. And Moran just slightly held up as well. Very bright start here for Chesterfield. Well, a bit late getting here, but there's no slouchiness about the play. Hampton really have just had we're 10 minutes in, I think Hampton have just had a couple of sporadic attacks. Here's Bird. Goes in central. Solomon. Out to Solomon. Solomon loses the fight there, and it's back down to Gellhardt on the left wing. Great play from Freddie Freight. And he's gone to find the big long ball up for Felinoff Sanev. Goalkeeper's out. Sanev gets a touch. This is going to be a goal for Hampton. Sanev has scored. Group one football. Goalkeeper commits. And Hampton against the run of play have scored after 11 minutes. Now here we are from the back, a long ball forward, and Sanef, who showed some great pace there. Goalkeeper's come out. It's one of those situations where it's so difficult for the goalkeeper. He thinks he can get there to help his defence, and then he realises he wishes he'd stayed on his line, because he's actually ended up making it easy for Rio Felinoff Sanef, who's entered again. What a tackle that is from Ryan Marsden. And if anything, Chesterfield are just as determined in this play. It's a good play there for Marcus Solomon to block that clearance. Causing a bit of trouble down the right side time and time again. Here's Dyer. Loving to see football that Chesterfield are putting together. Lovely interplay between the forward line. Loving every minute of it. Roberts and Wilson, Dyer, Moran, Gellhardt on the left. Charlie Hughes, who's fronting up as the centre forward at the moment, wearing the nine. Throw goes to Hughes. Gets a bit of a flick on. Hampton have plenty of people, plenty of players back for that. Seagraves. He's enjoying a few runs down the left himself. Fends the cross. Chesterfield retain possession. Inside from Wilson. Shot. Oh my God, what a shot that is! And it hits the top of the crossbar. Well, that was from long, long range. Probably the longest shot we've seen. Is this under 13s? I've got to recheck this. One touch and bang. And that was superb. Get a good view here. We'll get a great view from this angle, I'm sure. I see it like moves a little bit in the air as well. And did a bit of a Ronaldo, a bit of movement in the air as he hit that. Here's Moran again, who's already controlling his central midfield area. Good play from Solomon. Moran again. There's a calls of shoot from the crowd. What he might do this time around is a little bit closer. He's not happy with the pass. He's given a bit of attitude to his own player there for a loose pass. And here's Seagraves. Goes inside again. Dyer. Dyer looking to find Roberts, who's hanging out on the right wing all the time. Vinny will chase this down. More pressure. Dyer out to Roberts. He's staying back in the right back position. He's not going for the overlap. Misplaced pass there from Dyer, and Hampton regain possession. Nice play from Felix Burt.
floors from the left-hand side of the stadium below me, where the Hampton fans are sitting. Photographer just going past me below, taking lots of pictures of all the teams here. He's a busy old man. At least he sleeps in his bed each night. He lives in this area. Travels the length and breadth of the country, covering schools football. It's nice to see a few familiar faces back after all that COVID nonsense. Here's a ball passing, and well, there's a call for a shot again, and he's going to go for it again this time. But Harrison Wilson over the bar. I just remember one of the funniest moments I had with Gary. He was walking past with his camera in his arm, and just as he's doing now, actually, behind the right-hand goal. And somebody had a shot, and it hit him on the back. He dropped a few things, and... I've just turned my microphone off and did the most manic laugh that filled the whole stadium. And the fans below were wondering who was laughing at him. He was giggling away. He had to be there, really. Oh, here's a chance. Gerhardt just his control, let him down early on. Ball's played long. Chesterfield, Vinu here. Chesterfield, just constant pressure. Surely there's a ball coming. Moran goes back. Lawson looking out left for Seagraves, changes his mind. Decides to go down the centre himself. Seagraves gets the ball eventually. Charlie Hughes. Hampton have got a lot of players back. They've got bodies behind the ball. The proverbial buses being parked at the moment by Hampton, with just Sanaf on his own up front, battling away, going direct. Here's Solomon. He gets the shot in, but at the moment, it's all one-way traffic from Chesterfield. That's probably the fourth foray we've seen from Hampton in this match, but they do have the goal on the board. Vinu inside to Dyer. Of space. Direct ball very quickly up to Hughes and offside. He's appealing why. Now I think he's realised there was a free kick for a push or something, and it was actually offside. Sanev gets the ball back. Here's Burtz. Bit of pressure in the centre, cleared by Wilson. Here comes Wilson again. It's a lovely ball out to Gerhardt. Takes a rough one there, and he's back up, chasing the ball down. Sanaf just loses his footing there. Hampton do have players up on this move. They've pushed a few up. Oh, right. Nice play from Moran. He's been very good in that centre midfield position. Finds Gerhardt. Great crossfield ball for Roberts. Having a real tussle with Felix Burt up there. Those two are very equally matched. A similar body size, stature. receives the throw. Yeah. Charlie Hughes, number nine, is caught out in the right position and Barry gets the free kick, so chance for a few players to come from the back and see Joshua Lawson up there. But a few big lads in this Chesterfield team. Isaac Mamad, probably the tallest player on the pitch at the moment, is getting in there into the edge of the six-yard box. Just have to wait for a lace to be done first. As you can see, the goalkeeper is not the tallest. He's already shown he's very happy to get the ball out. There's definitely calls coming in from Chesterfield to pop this into the six-yard box. They're confident that they're going to get ahead to this. Chipped in there. At the back to the far post. It's loose in the six-yard box. And the referee spotted a little push as the ball was in the air. No doubt there's a little bit of change there for Chesterfield, isn't there, with this particular type of ball, and there's no major height in the Hampton team perhaps, apart from centre forward Zanev, who may have to come back for all these any corners or free kicks. That's a lovely turn from Dyer. He's won the ball again. That's superb. Wilson looking for Gerhardt. Gerhardt comes inside it and just gets his foot underneath it. Got a bit too excited. Yeah, got a bit thin up there. Again, another Chesterfield attack that looked really threatening. Plenty of time left to go. Only 22 minutes on the clock. Through the middle here, Hampton, battling away, Salmon. He's edged out the ball there by Lawson. Seagrave clears his line, and he finds Moran in a bit of space here. Moran plays a super ball down the line, and Gerhardt just can't control. Loose ball there from Malik at the back. Gives the ball straight to Chesterfield. Vinu into Dyer, looking to find Hughes up front, who's not had a lot of ball considering Chesterfield's possession. Vinu's not going to be able to keep that one in. Have to get a bit of a breather here. They've been so under the cosh. Wait. Went to Gerhardt, flicks the ball on. Dyer. Looking to play Vinu in, but goes wide. Just likes to play that pass out to Roberts on the right. Just a little bit too much on it. Referee's had enough of a little bit of chat here from Charlie Hughes. Yes, early substitution here. Marcus Solomon is off and Alex Watson, number 14, is on. Another substitution as well. So Faris Salman is off, and And on comes Finley Miller, Milner. Excuse me, so I think this is good management here. We're 25 minutes in, halfway through the first half. It really feels like only a matter of time before Chesterfield are going to score. And, well, this is the way to do something about it, I guess. Make a few changes and try and swap something around in that midfield. Both look to have come in into the midfield area, which is where the problem has been for Hampton. At the moment, Moran is absolutely rampaging around this pitch, but he has lost out to the substitute, and there's a foul on the Finley Milner. Chesterfield making a change as well. Dan Gerhardt is coming off. And Ben Pennington is on. Now you see the foul on him. These teams have played a lot of matches to get through here. This is round 10, can you believe? One of the biggest competitions going in England Schools FA. PlayStation FC is competition. All wearing lovely PlayStation kits. Now, in the first round, they had a 10-0 win against Ormskirk School, but in round two, they played Formby High School, and they were 4-1 down in that match in the third round, and went on to win 6-5. What a game that was! 4-3 to Formby at half time. It was a fairly tight match as they played Mosselin School. It was a 2-1 win there in round 4. Just break off a second here as dangerous balls played forward. Free kick. Been a number of tight matches all the way through this competition for Chesterfield. They've not had it easy, you've got to say that. And having a lot of fun out there at the moment, but well, that ball's misplaced. And here's a 2-on-1 for Hampton if it goes to feet, but it doesn't. Inside, here's the substitute, Milner. To try and play the other substitute in at the back, Watson. And Watson almost gets in the end of that as well off a rebound. And now here's Pennington, the Chesterfield substitute, on a bit of a break. But Hampton have got players back, six players back, only two Chesterfield players forward. Hampton are just not committing many players. They truly are getting men behind the ball here. Falling off Sanev, well, he's using his bulk there to shrug players aside. I think that's his style of play. He wants to play that way. He wants the big ball up and to have a little bit of a scuffle and a fight with the defender. Well, not literally, of course, but he's offside there. Man ball forward. Just looking through the result, they had in round 6, it was a 4-3 win over Neston High School. 4-0 away victory against Wilmslow in Manchester in round 7. In round 8, a home victory in the quarterfinal against Priestnell School, and it was a 4-1 away victory against Ashfield School. So they had some tough games earlier on in the competition, did Chesterfield. But it's just slipping at the important time there. Here's Milner. Milner's looked good once since he's come on, but Moran dispossesses him. Looks to play in Roberts. Sorry, Hughes there. Noah Roberts is actually the top scorer. The number 11. Noah Roberts on the ball right now. 8 goals to his name. Out of the 43 scored by Chesterfield in this competition. So the goals have been spread out widely amongst the team. Handball there given against Fernand off Sanev. here's Pinnington. Came on for Dan Gelhart, who's the brother of Joe Gelhart, who played for the same school. He's now playing with Leeds United in the Premiership. Corner is difficult, hits the top of the crossbar. Wow. There was no doubt that they're going for the height inside the six-yard box to if feel there's a chance in there. Here's the replay. He's put some swerve on here. You almost think it's an attempt at goal, don't you? Straight from the corner. Around with a free header. No challenge at all. Totally dominant Chesterfield here, but 1-0 behind. Pinnington in with a challenge. Here's Seagrave. Back to Pinnington. Rafsanev does well. He's definitely busy. Wants the ball played in front, but he's not going to get it. Strauss. I've hardly mentioned a few of these Hampton players have just had none of the ball. When it's gone on the field, it's been Fanonov Sanev who's really been the man with it. And his support, just haven't seen much of the ball. Here's a ball through for Hughes. Goalkeeper's come out and does really well. And the goalkeeper's taken a bit of a clatter afterwards. Hughes offers his hand, but just he needs a little bit of treatment here. Can just see a replay about it. No, I thought that the referee may actually give a foul for this because Hughes has come in, it's been kicked out, and then there's a collision afterwards. And yeah, that's usually a foul. Well, the referee gets to see that on the big screen as well. one of the not so good features about refereeing in a ground with a big screen is the crowd gets to see everything afterwards, and you do as well. He's going to win a corner, so more pressure on the Hampton defence here. Fenonov Sanev has scored a lot of goals, 16 goals out of the 45 scored by his team, so they really are relying on this man up front. Boy, of course, we're talking about the 13s here. Ball's gone out of play, hits the crossbar again. Well, they're getting good at this. Crossbar challenge, but from a corner is a lot harder. Not from a counter spot. Chesterfield a 2-from-2, but they'd rather have it going in the goals, of course. Nice crowd here. Has he noticed us on the screen yet? Yes, he has. Gives us a hello. He's transfixed. Is that what I really look like? Shock every day I look in the mirror. Seagraves. Even the goal kick's always good. It seems to be just going to a Chesterfield shirt every time. Moranu's absolutely running this show at the moment. Looks to play in Roberts, so up on the right wing. Bit of pressure behind from Stouts, who's a number of these players are actually forward players and just having to defend at the moment. They're running and chasing the ball. Here's Seagraves. Got players in the box for the cross. Back to Milner. 1 minute added time. Well, this has gone very quickly here. I'm not like holding on to it. There's a dangerous cross. It's three in the six-yard box and cleared. Sheer numbers at the back for Hampton. Here's Dyer. Dyer has a go. Well blocked. That was Malik with the block there. Now the opposite number four, Lawson. Lawson will have a go. And he's appealing for a corner. The referee says having none of it. Says goal kick. interesting first half this has been. It's been, it feels like it's something like 80% possession. It's a very one-sided game. Good play. Here's Hampton looking to push. Foul goes Hampton's way as well. Chanting to push forward, and well, there isn't, because there's the whistle. So half time is on the clock. And what an interesting first half this has been. Chesterfield with everything in this game, dominating midfield, just coming up against a yellow brick wall of Hampton defence, who are, I said earlier, parking the bus. I'm not saying they're parking, you know, they're going for attacks when they can. But when the opposition have got the ball, they are definitely getting bodies behind and very, very difficult to break down. Been a number of chances. We've seen a few scrambles in that six-yard box. We've seen the bar hit. But here at half-time, Chesterfield High School 0, Hampton School 1. Here are some of the major chances, and well, there's a lot. You're going to see a lot in this direction. This one, almost an own goal. And I've got to say, I felt the defender did very, very well here. This is the goal, and Felinov Sanev, this is his style. He wants that ball over the top. Goalkeeper's made it a little bit easy for him. He's got the toe and converts. And yeah, the frustration there, because I think Joshua Lawson felt that he'd actually got control of the situation and looked up and realised his goalie had come out. This is the quandary of being a goalkeeper in these sort of situations. Do you leave it or do you come out? And I think he made the judgment his defender was in trouble. And, well, there you go. This was an incredible shot from the man. Let's fly, absolutely pelts it against the crossbar. I don't think the goalkeeper was anywhere near that. Another angle of this. This is probably a better angle from here. Goalkeeper throws an arm up, but he's not getting anywhere near that ball. That was the big chance for Moran. Lots of other little half chances here and there. We saw the crossbar hit from a corner, and but it's definitely the word has got out. We have a shorter goalkeeper in goal for Chesterfield, and they're definitely trying to go for the high tactic. But so far, Chesterfield still have a clean sheet. We'll find out what happens in the second half shortly.
Excuse me, let me jump in.
Do you know whenever you're in maths or English or whatever it is, always like, stop talking, stop making noise. You can make as much noise as you want in a hall for once. Oh. 1, 2, 3. And get to sleep in the moment. That's loud. She can hear you, right?
Chesterfield's way. more substitutions by the look of it. We've kept pretty much the teams that left the pitch. Another look through results of these two teams have been pushed close on more than one occasion. It's a highly competitive field. Schools FA, I heard earlier, 5,000 teams have entered across various categories. There's a lot of the elite, just a handful of teams. Heads forward to centre spine of Chesterfield team with Wilson, Moran and Hughes. We really like this player as well. Noah Roberts put a lot of work in on this right hand side. Moran to Roberts, wants to return, doesn't get it but still runs into space. Wilson goes wide left to Seagraves. Pinning at Milner. Sorry, that's Pinnington, of course. Here's a chance. Chance and score. Chesterfield, it was coming all along. And a goal. The equaliser. Players are falling around all over the place right here. It's the number nine, Charlie Hughes, who scores. Defender doesn't clear, and in the end, puts the ball back across his own goal. And Hughes was there waiting for it. And now game is on here. Headed back across there by Felix Burt. I'm not sure if he had a player behind him. He may have felt that he had a player behind him. He had to get ahead on it and do something. In the end, he put it into the path of Hughes, who planted it in the back of the net. So, well, here we are, there's only 3 minutes on the clock. They battled away for 35 minutes. Didn't really have a massive chance. There's some great shots from outside the box, and here we are 3 minutes later in the second half, and they get the goal. But thoroughly deserved, you've got to say. Throw's gone long. There's Strouts, plays it across, cleared by Seagraves. Hughes, a little bit more buoyant and confident now after that goal under his belt. Moran plays it beautifully out to Roberts. Moran on the overlap yet again. Stoner's put some serious miles in this match. Vinu. Here's Moran, comes in on the inside. To Felix Burt. Puts paid to that attack. Suhu Jin. It's a good ball down the line. Sanoff is chasing it. And in the end, Marsden has to just put it out of play. Possession in the Chesterfield half for the longest period in the match, to be honest, but here comes Chesterfield away with the ball now. Here's Vinu, looks to play in Hughes. Hughes gets the throw in. Found a way to get it into this game as well. Will be Vinu with the throw. Hughes. And Mangold's just spectacular overhead from the edge of the box. Calls off shoots to Seagraves. Decides he'd rather not. Let's build up the play. I've seen Moran's got a shot at him when possible. Vinu looks to play in Hughes. Nice little chip ball straight to Hughes' foot. This is great play from Dyer. Hughes likes to get on the back of it, and Suhu Jin just clears and, well, takes a bit of contact from Hughes afterwards. There's two players down on the pitch here in different parts. We're going to need a bit of treatment here. So Vinu with the ball has just been stopped for a second while both players just rub their joints, get back up. Sorry, that wasn't that was a Cardinale there. Oh, that's just a fraction above Pennington, who's coming in on that, in front of, right in front of goal on the 60-yard line. Suhu Jin. There's a chase from Solomon, who's back on the pitch. Was substituted earlier, so there has been a little bit of movement. And Felinov Sanev is just not getting any ball whatsoever. Not even getting the long distance hopefuls that he was getting a few times in the first half. Nice bit of football here. Kasper Strauss will try and take Vinu on. He gets the throw. A good foot to that. He's first man back, as well as pushing forward in midfield. He's doing his box-to-box job very well here today. Burt. A little bit of football possession inside the Chesterfield half here. Burt. Played from Mallet. Burt's a shrugged off the ball by Dyer, though, and Dyer now looking to play Hughes in. Good to see Hampton just getting a little bit more possession. Cardinale clears down the line. Vinu. Nice little turn from Vinu there. Every option of a pass was blocked off for a second and created a nice angle himself. Moran. Beautiful ball out with the left foot. Four Chesterfield players moving into the box. Hughes goes up, it's cleared by Cardinale. Dyer loses out. Felinov Sanev manages to hold the ball up well and tries to play Marcus Solomon in, but he loses his footing. Ben Pinnington shoots aside there by Thwaite. Felinov Sanev is he's putting in a lot of yardage here without really getting a lot of ball. Chasing around, one man up on his own, totally. Starting to look a little bit dejected out there, got to be said. It's a tough gig for the Sol centre forward. Here's Roberts, really like Roberts' play. He might even have a go here, and he does, and it's Schaefer post. Goalkeeper's kicked it early. Shot from distance, well over the bar. Not missed anything here. Shot from very long distance, which was never really going to trouble the goalkeeper. Goalkeeper's up in the seats, trying to retrieve the ball now. Goalkeeper's taking a risk there against Solomon. Chesterfield have worked themselves back into this game, but don't be giving an easy goal away here. Solomon has definitely pushed up further since he came back on than he was earlier in this game. Just trying to give Hampton a bit of depth. Still got this sort of 4-1-3-2 line. But four, the one and the three are so far back. It's just literally two up front now. And occasionally somebody on the overlap when they've got possession. Again, possession given away. Hughes, goal scorer, blocked by Cardinale. Fanon Ofsanov looking to get on the end of this, but you can see the body language is starting to tell up there for the Hampton centre forward. Ball's being played quickly. You really don't need to be doing that. Just giving the ball away too easily. Oh, ball's into space like that also. Just a giveaway for Hampton at the moment. Roberts asking for the ball out wide and he gets it from Milan. What a ball that is. Roberts will take on his defender, but brilliant play there from Felix Burt. He's up against the top player and Burt handled it really well. Roberts again finds himself a bit of space out on the wing. And Burt again stands straight up to him and dispossesses twice in a row. Substitution here is Rio Felinov-Sanov, the captain, who is seems to have just completely run out of energy. He's put a lot of work there. You can just see the way he's running off. His head's all over the place. He needs a good rest. And he's making way for Omer Olsa. Now, whether that's going to mean a slight change in how Hampton are going to play. They've certainly not been playing the long ball in the second half, trying to be in play a little bit more on the ground, and so maybe that substitution could suit Hampton a little bit more than he might have felt. Shouts out from the crowd to individuals on the pitch. Just a little bit of quiet descent on us for a second. I'll just get their breath back as well. It's been quite loud in here today. So Balti Burtz comes off, and Faris Salman, who lasted about 25 minutes in the first half, has had his rest and he's coming on now. Feel the game has changed a little bit here. A few substitutions. Hampton just having a little bit more possession than they've ever had in this match so far. Score still 1-1. I feel we've just entered a different phase of this match here. Quite a lot of changes of personnel. Let's see what difference that makes. It's a nice ball out wide. Here's also the substitute who's basically basing himself on the left wing. Salman. Ball's gone high, but there's nobody there. There's no height in the Hampton team. And that's a lovely turn inside by Milner. He's got Moran all over him. And Chesterfield managed to clear. Also. Slowly break forward. Good ball from Pennington going out further left. Here's Seagraves, the left back, who's always roaming up. That's a good ball back. Wilson looking to get on the end of that. Could have been dangerous, but Suhu Jin yet again has been an absolute stalwart at the back. Him and Cardinale have had a lot of pressure against them, and they've managed to stand up to everything so far. Salmon. Here's Solomon. Solomon gets the 1-2 back. Seagraves puts the ball out, but Solomon, lovely bit of skill. The referee, play on. They've given the free kick while Solomon was through there. And he was looking up to play Olser, who was on the left wing, completely clear. Referee's just spotted Vinu doing his laces up, but he's finished, so we play continues. Olser. Nice little first-time ball, but my man plays a first-time ball himself, and here's Roberts. He's having a great battle against Burks here. I'm really enjoying this tussle between these two. Vinu under big pressure from Olser. And that will be a throw for Hampton. Definite little change in the breeze out there. Hampton getting more possession. Never change here. Charlie Hughes, the goal scorer, is coming off. And Tom Windsor is coming on. I'm just not sure, is this a like for like? Looks like Windsor is going to go into midfield role. And Josh Lawson, who has been playing at the back, has gone straight up front. So there's a few little tweaks there. I'm not sure who's gone into the back area. We'll have to look at that. Oh, that was played with the wrong foot. Seagraves, who's got a great left foot, obviously not a very good right foot. Gets a free kick as Noah Roberts takes a little knock from his nemesis for today's match, who is called Felix Burt. Just having a look at what's happened here. Looks like it's a long ball. Suhu Jin under pressure, and Burt tidies up. Vinu under big pressure there from Strout. And Hampton looking a little bit more energetic in this second half, aren't they? Man comes to put pressure on. That's a lovely little chip ball over Olser. Olser looking for options. He's got them. Here's Strout. Vinu's right on him straight away. Lovely turn from Strout. And there's players up here for Hampton. Solomon with the ball. Keeper's out like a shot. Good play from Hampton School here. Turning this match around, and a few of the Chesterfield players are looking at each other a little bit, going, well, what's going on here? But here's an opportunity. Lawson, look at the pace from Suhu Jin. He looks like quite a stocky build, but when he opened up, that was serious pace from, well, I wouldn't guess, but possibly Korean descent. So many matches, you're just not able to do any homework on any teams, of course, apart from some of the basics about passed rounds and etc. Here's Vinu under early pressure, and he's actually given the ball away there. Here's Milner inside to Salmon. Solomon. Challenge there. And on Marsden. Free kick. It looks like Wilson has dropped back. Player sort of more defensive position, but he's also pushing up, so sort of they're almost like three at the back of Chesterfield. But yes, yeah, a push from Wilson given there. Free kick, referee's very sharp on that. Crowd are getting a bit noisy again. They've had their rest, they're back on the fizzy pond, and away we go. We're a bit more chanting for their team. 15 minutes to go in this match. We haven't had penalties yet, but we have penalties now. Here's Vinu, looks down the line. He's got a bit of space here for Lawson, who seems to have a lot of energy to burn. I think he's had quite a lot of Well, that ball looks a bit too long. Lawson's been on the pitch from minute one. Well, of course, playing at the back, he's possibly not had a lot to do. He seems to have a lot of energy out there as he's been moved forward.
Here's Solomon.
See the change in style as Hampton are playing this ball on the ground a bit. There's a free kick, rightly called by the referee, Ryan Marsden, bringing down Kasper Strauss. As soon as Felinov Sanev has gone off, that long ball technique has disappeared, and Hampton are playing through the midfield, which seems to be a style that they're enjoying more. If you want to vote for your friend to get a nice big trophy that's got Man of the Match written on it, then get along to the PlayStation, sorry, to the school's FA Twitter account. And there are four players that are listed. I have my own choice, although unfortunately there's no trophy attached to my choice. Moran and Roberts for Chesterfield, Suhujin and Burt for Hampton. It might be a clue in how this match has gone, the fact that the two defenders for Hampton have been chosen and two attacking players for Chesterfield, because that's basically most of the football we've seen here today as Cardinale clears the ball out. Chesterfield going to make another change here. So Vinu, Wee Wong Waller. God, I've got the name and he's coming off. No way. I've had to call him Vinu all match and now he's Wee Wong Waller.
Oh, there you go.
But he's off and on comes Harrison Brennan.
I do apologise, but that name is definitely a mouthful and it just clicked there as he was coming off. Such is life.
Seagraves. Plenty of space down the left-hand side. And Hampton are, well, they're almost like decamped. It's almost basketball style. They're decamped in their own box, waiting for the ball to come in. And, well, they've got numbers in there. This is the proverbial bus almost. They're playing very narrow. They're letting Chesterfield have the ball out wide. Here's Burt. Hopes to play in. But that's not such a good ball. Wilson. Charged down by Strauss. Another substitute. Well, the board's gone up. Hampton School, number four, is Adam Malik. He's going off. And coming back on is Balti Burks. Chesterfield 14 is off. And it's Wilson that's gone off. And Harry Williams is on. Strauss. Ryan Marsden did a good job on him there. Just to handle that. Playing football out from the back as well. Great to see. Birch returns. Here's Milner. Milner's eyeing up a potential shot, but well, Sammy Dyer, who's been a little bit quiet the last 10 minutes, he's been playing a little bit more of a defensive role. I think he fancies more to. Definitely got a lot more change out of the attacking side of things in the first half. Game hangs in the balance, doesn't it? Solomon. There's the substitute also. Looking to play in Solomon. Fierce challenge from Seagraves. Milner. Playing that Ulster again, but he's got Marsden right on him. Wondered if there might be a foul there, but the referee said no. And the referee says nothing going there either. Well, it's getting a little bit out of control here, and I think, well, two tackles, and there's booze all around, and at one stage it was looking like it was going to boil over a little bit. I think that I can see why the referee, both players were sort of almost going down already when the challenge came in. Yeah, here's the second one. He's sort of, look, you see he's already going down, and then there's a little bit of a touch from Burt, but Burt was just trying to get to the ball. I think the referee's actually done the right thing there. He was already going down. He'd have been down anyway. I don't think Burt actually made him go down. Well, there was possibly contact there, so. But you see now, it's getting a little bit bad-tempered, and the referee is going to go to his card. And he's booking Moran there for, obviously, a little bit of the verbals. He's quite upset, the referee, actually. He's brandished that yellow card about five times in his face. Okay, he needs to just control his temper a little bit here. We don't want to see anything silly like a red going in a game like this. But he's taking a bit of stick for that decision, and there's going to be a substitution. Well, Noah Roberts comes off. He's been an absolute revelation, this kid on the right wing. Really enjoyed watching him. And it's Charlie Hughes, who's not been off the pitch too long, to be honest. He's had a little rest. He comes back on. He scored the goal. He looks like he's going back up front. So Alfie Williams is coming on. And Ben Pennington makes way for him. So lots of changes again. Hughes is back on up front. Looks like Lawson's gone back again. We'll work out in the next few minutes who's playing where now. But oh no, Lawson stayed up on the right wing. Balti Burtz has gone down, and I think he just lost his footing there. Lawson with the cross, and goalkeeper. I like his style. He knew that wasn't going anywhere near. So it looks like Lawson has taken the position on the right-hand side that Noah Roberts was playing in. Given this time, fascinating match this. Burtz, that's a good long distance hit. Chesterfield on the counter. Hughes looking to play in Windsor. And Windsor keeping the ball, doing well there. Windsor corner. Few wary legs here for Chesterfield. They've dominated this match for such long periods. I think that doesn't come without a bit of payback, and I think there's a few legs. I think Moran's starting to feel it a little bit. He has really been on top in this game, and even he's starting to feel it out there now. Corner. It's a good corner kick right into the heart of the six-yard line. Cardinale wins a superb header under intense pressure there. Options, Lawson. Not going south, but that's dangerous. He's only running into players, and that's a lovely ball down the left wing. And here's a break from Hampton. There's a few Hampton players in the middle with their heads down. Here comes Strouts. He might go all the way here, Strouts. Saved by Sean Beatles in goal. Brilliant play. There's another shot from just outside the box of Burtz. Wow. What a game. Kasper Strouts, who just made that run, I think he's going to be quite happy coming up for a rest after that. And Rio Falunov-Sanev is coming back on up front, and he's a handful, we know. Be interesting to see how things develop now he's playing. up front, because Hampton are definitely at least an equal in this game right now. Omar also is off. Alfie Williams is coming on for his first spell on the pitch. Is it me? There's only 4 minutes left in this game. This is absolutely shot by. It's been such an enjoyable football match. And there's every chance of penalties now. We've not had penalties so far this week. With these young kids, it's been a really great game out there, but it's going to be a hero and a villain. And well, Chesterfield are pushing up, they're getting all the big bodies in the box now. They've got over a couple of bigger lads on as subs as well. They really are, do have a high advantage, with the exception of possibly Suju, Suhu Jin and Cardinale. Swing the corner in, just outside the box, a winning header from Milan. Sorry, that was Hughes. Wow. Here we see. So Kasper Strutz is coming back on. He's only been off about 2 minutes. Change their mind, and Solomon is coming off. I wonder if this is with penalties in mind. So obviously we literally have two or three minutes left, and maybe there's a thought of who are the good penalty takers in there. Going to happen in these next few moments? Who will take the trophy home? Thwaite had a fantastic, to be honest, you've got to say every one of the Hampton players has done a superb job at the back. They probably feel as if they played two games here today, such as the pressure they've had. Harry Williams needs to take on his player, but out there, Josh Gorgon. Sorry, I called him Alfie Williams there. I'm looking at the long sheet for a second, but it's Josh Gorgon there. Here's Harry Williams, number 14. Inside for Dyer, who's been quite quiet in his second half. Bodies in here, Mahan looking to come in on the back post, and another corner. Suhu Jin heads that one out. 1 minute to go in normal time. Seagraves comes off for captain, and Dan Gelhardt is on. Seagraves has been on the whole match. Chesterfield players all crowding that six-yard box, and Cardinale wins the header, but the referee sees a little nudge in there. Goalkeeper's wanting to play this one quickly, but the referee's not having that one, and he really wasn't in the right position anyway. Was an opportunity. Dan Gelhardt asking where he's going to be playing, and back and pump to the left wing where you were in the first half. 4 minutes additional time has been put up on the board. Chesterfield, you feel they're really pushing this hard. They want to try and win this here and now. Don't want to go to the lottery for penalties. Hampton will get a throw. Well, do get on your vote for player of the match. I think the four names are on there. All very valid, I think, for different reasons.
another substitution below us. And
number five is off. Ryan Marsden is off. And Noel Roberts is back on. So
I wonder if that is one of these penalty substitutions now, because that definitely isn't like for like. Marsden's a defender and Roberts is, well, he's on the right wing, although he seems to be standing around at the back at the moment, so I think it is a penalty kick competition substitution. Roberts certainly not be used to playing in that position. Just over 2 minutes to go. Nelson Benand with the throw. Didn't go for the longer throw, so that's not so long after all. Come a little bit free, and oh, just wide of the post. That would have been lucky, you've got to say. He just swung the foot in the block. Here's another sub. I'm getting tired of all these subs. 12 is off and 4 is on. So Finlay Myrna is off, Adam Malik is on. Here's, well, there you go. He swung the leg out, did Dyer. So close to going in. What an enjoyable game. So much good football played here. Chesterfield pushing forward. Referee said there's nothing doing there. That was a fair challenge. Cardinale heads it clear. And he finds Windsor. A long ball and, well, Fulham offside. He's been feeding on just tidbits all along, hasn't he? He's just not had any service at all. It's always been the high ball and him shrugging around with a couple of defenders on him. Burt. Burt with the throw. Receives it back. Clears his lines. Ross Sanneth. Little dummy there, and Salmon plays it out wide, and Hampton have players forward on his attack. They had a 4-on-3 there when you looked up. Suhu Jin pushes Hughes, free kick to Chesterfield. Surely this is going to be the last move of the match. Sanef is being told to get back as well. Can't really see there being enough time for Hampton to get up, but on that previous attack it was quite a shock. Hampton pushed a couple of players up on the blind side, and when you looked up you realised they were actually at a man advantage. My man is gone, he's actually gone for the shot, and that will be the last kick of the actual action here. And now it's penalty kicks. And now the moment. Here we go. Chance for the goalkeepers to become a hero. While they decide who's going to take penalty kicks, let's just have a look at the two goals from this match. There was chances all over the place. Just rewind on YouTube if you want to watch them. There was so much. Here's the first goal from Fallon off Sanevan. Well, that was the pace on the kick definitely caught them out there, and Sanev getting a touch on the ball. That's the first goal, much against the run of play. It truly was a dominant performance. Long distance ball from Freddie Thwaite. And Fenon of Sanev guts the sprint on. The goalkeeper commits, makes the decision easy. And how cool is that as he just walks away? He goes, yeah, there's a goal. He's not really celebrating, is he? He's too cool to celebrate. Here's the equaliser.
Yeah, a bit of confusion at the back. Burke's just trying to head it, but not getting the clearance. And it fell to Hughes, who puts the ball into the back of the goal. Feel sorry for Burt there. He's had a great game. He was under pressure there from Noah Roberts, as he had, well, he'd been dealing with Noah Roberts all game. And just trying to clear it, but didn't get a solid head on it. And in the end, pushing the ball back for Hughes. Penalties to come. Hold on to your hats. Penalty. First goal for Hampton. Alessandro Cardinale, who's had a wonderful game. His action in this final is over unless we go come all back and to get for more kicks, which is possible. Cardinale scores. Next up. Thank you. and put it into the opposite corner, getting towards pressure moments. Next up, centre forward for Chesterfield, the goal scorer. It's a long walk, isn't it? It's that a long walk, making them stand on the halfway line and they have to come all this way. Charlie Hughes has to make it 3-0.
School against Kingsdale Foundation School.
two top teams going head-to-head here. Teams we've seen in many finals before, and at under 15 level, we're going to see some of the best football we've seen all week. Stay tuned for that. First of all, the trophy presentation for the under-13s.
Two sides will need to catch up with both team managers in just a short while. obviously we just played their hearts out, which I really did have every ounce of energy on that match.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, we could go into a little bit of cliches.
This is your chance to give an apology to the moms and dads, because I saw there was a lot of nervous faces in the crowd. You went through hell about that issue.
I actually turned to my fellow coach and said,
so we've had one final, we've got another one to come. You're under.